Good morning, friends. This is our English period, and we are going to learn the lesson, Madam Rides the Bus. So when actually we have started the lesson yesterday, that time we have noticed that Madam means we have decided that Madam will be one of the lady who is in middle of the age. So that particular lady we can say Madam. But actually when we have gone through the lesson, first two parts, so we have understood that this is not the big lady or middle-aged lady, it is a very small girl of 8 years old, but her maturity was like a lady. So that we have learned. Also we have learned that Valli, who has strong desire, deepest desire to travel by the bus, actually she doesn't have any schoolmate or a playmate to play with. That is why she used to see from her door many things, and most common thing which she used to see, that was the bus which rides in her village to town. And that is why the temptation has come in her mind that I will ride one day to town. And then she acquired all the information regarding the trip, that how far the town from her village. Then she have understood that around 6 miles away. Then what is the fare of that? She has taken all the review, all the knowledge by surrounding people, and then she started the bus journey. When she has started, that time she has got a very jolly person as a conductor, and for, at the initial stage the conductor was very comic with her. After that he understood about her character, that she is very sharp and very smart girl. Then he in middle he used to make some jokes and all. Many elderly persons have suggested some ways to that girl, Miss Valli, but she had not listened anyone, because she thought that all the people, all the passengers from the bus are thinking that she is very small girl. But actually according to her, she was a bit mature, because she was traveling by her own money. And the person who is traveling by her own money, it means he has all rights as other passengers have. And then she goes, then we have seen that one of the elderly person says that please sit down, otherwise you fall down. That also she didn't like. And then afterwards, at one of the stop, when the lady has got inside into the bus, and she was chewing betel nut. And that smell and the juice of the betel nut was irritating Valli. And that is why, and she said that she has asked in a very careful way, where you want to go, or do you know the house number, do you know the street number? She said, I don't want to care from your side, and till we have stopped. You did not bother about me, I can take care of myself, Valli said, turning her face towards the window and staring outside. So while the journey, she enjoyed a lot the outer scenario of the nature, because it was unprecedented for her to see such type of locality, such type of scenery. And that was, she was very very wondered, she was very happy, she was very delighted by this journey. So till we have learned in this two part, we'll go in the third part. Actually this lesson have four parts, so already we have learned two part and I just revise it properly. Now we'll go in third part. Her first journey was careful, painstaking, means very diligent with care, because she has taken proper care. It was good planning, it was good strategy behind the journey. Elaborate plans she had to make for it, because a girl of 8 years old traveling alone with her own money which she has saved, it is not that easy. It was very difficult, and she is going by alone without informing her or without letting known her to her mother that she had done. So it was something different. Good plan, good management, very good risk management also we can understand by her activity. She had thriftily saved whatever stray coins came her way. Thriftily means very secretly she has saved that. Whatever money, maybe some aunt has given or some mother has given, that is all money she had saved. She stored without noticing. So at the same time, she has stopped her, controlled her temptation to eat, temptation to enjoy something. Because as a small kid or small child, we have different aspiration. We want to eat chocolate, we want to eat lollies or some different kinds of toys we want to purchase. But she has controlled everything there. So that is why she could successful in her plan. Resisting every temptation to buy peppermint, toys, balloons and the like. And finally, she had saved a total of 60 paise. So 60 paise, this amount is very small, actually very, very, minor amount if we think right now. Now we can save 6,000 rupees also, because this is the era where money has not that value, which was earlier days. How difficult it had been for her to collect 60 paisa. Particularly that day at the village fair, but she had resolutely controlled with a determination, a strong desire to ride in the merry-go-round. You went in the fair and you will not see the merry-go-round, then it is very ununderstanding thing, or it is very totally disappointing for any kid. He or she will complain to her father or mother, or will beg to her father or mother, please, I want to sit in the merry-go-round. But she has stopped her temptation. She stopped her strong desire to sit on that, because she want to save some money to have a ride in a bus. After she had enough money saved, her next problem was how to sleep out of the house without her mother's knowledge, because mother will not let her go outside. And if mother will come, it was not possible for to convince her mother. That is why she has to go without informing mother. And an 8 years old girl cannot go alone with the consent of mother. It would have not possible. That is why she has to go without telling her mother. And that she did. But she managed this without too much difficulty. Every day after lunch, her mother would nap from about 1 to 4 or so. So she had properly noticed it. She has studied well, and this was very well studied plan. She has acknowledged, or she has known very well, that her mother, after her completion of the work, household work, she used to sleep for 1 to 4, and between that she has to come. Already we know that 1 to 145, that time will cover to that particular town, then again 15 minutes to waiting period, and again 2 to 2:45 she will come back. So without noticing her mother, she could come back, or she can come back. That plan was there, and it was properly well planned. Every day after lunch, her mother would nap from about 1 to 4 or so. Wally always used to these hours for her excursions, as she stood looking for the doorways of her house, or sometimes even ventured out, means what? Ventured out into the village. Today, this same hours could be used for her first excursion outside the village. So she has certain history that she used to go without letting her mother know that where she goes every day. So in meanwhile, she used to go in a village to roam somewhere, because she is a very different girl. She was not that girl who liked to play with the chulmandi or something like hide and seek, nothing of that sort. She was different. She wanted to roam in the nature. She wanted to see each and everything outside of the world. The bus rolled on now, cutting across the bare landscape. Now rushing through a tiny hamlet, means very small village, or past an old wayside shop. Sometimes the bus seemed on the point of swallow up another vehicle that was coming towards them, or a pedestrian crossing the road. And many times when we travel, that time we feel that now we will have dash with another vehicle. But driver manages that, because they are driver and they know very well how to drive the bus or how to drive the vehicle. Like that, sometimes pedestrian comes in middle and then they have to brake the vehicle, everything. That scenario we have seen already. And same thing happened, because this was the first time when Valli was traveling somewhere. And that is why she was very cautious. My God, what will happen there? But at that moment, driver manages it properly. But lo, somehow it passed on smoothly, leaving all obstacles safely behind. Trees came running towards them, but then stopped as the bus reached them and simply stood there helpless for a moment by the side of the road before rushing away in the other direction. We have seen that one song in Marathi, Jhuku 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 Agin A Gaadi, Dhuran Chari Shahave The Gaadi, Pati Zhaade Pahoya, right? So when we go into the bus, that time we feel that trees are running behind us. So that was the, we have seen that. So like that, suddenly Valli clapped her hands with a glee, Miss Joy, big delightment. A young cow, tail high in the air, was running very fast right in the middle of the road. Right in front of the bus slowed to crawl. You know that when any animal comes in the middle when vehicle is going on, that time it becomes so afraid. We have seen that it becomes so afraid and then it began to run. Like that same happened when cow, yellow color cow, has come in across the bus, and because she was afraid, she was running like anything. Okay, keeping her tail high in the air, and she was running like anything, and it was very, funny picture, funny movement picture she has seen. She was laughing very loudly that tears comes out from her eyes. That much she was happy, that much she has enjoyed the moment. But the more he honked, and side away that cow, driver was honking her. Or honked her, but she didn't pay attention. She was frightened, and the more frightened the animal became, and faster it galloped, always right in front of the bus he used to come there. Somehow this was very funny to Valli. She laughed and laughed until there were tears in her eyes. So she has a great laughter there. "Hey lady, haven't you laughed enough?" said the conductor. "Hey lady," even though it was something like a very controversy, or we can say ironically, he said, "Hey lady, haven't you laughed enough? Miss, you have laughed enough, now stop it. Now stop it," called the conductor. "Better save for tomorrow, and this laughter now don't. Will you finish your laughter today itself? You have to keep some laughter for tomorrow also. Don't laugh, miss. It means what? She has laughed a lot." At last, cow moved off to the road, and soon the bus came to the railroad crossing. A speck of a train could be seen in the distance. Speck means very small amount of the picture we can see of the train. She can see from there. So she was just trying to witnessing. She was just trying to see each and everything of the nature or far away side. So she has seen a very small speck of train, means what? Very small picture of the train. Then it rushed past the crossing gate with the tremendous roar and rattle, shaking the bus. Then when train passed away, so you know that very well that how it makes the noise. So roaring and vibrating our vehicle as well when we stop at the railway crossing when any train goes. Then how we feel? We feel the vibrations of the tram. The same thing happened with the Valli. From there, the transferred a busy well, and then she shifted to the busy, well laid out shopping street, and turning entered a wide thoroughfare. Thoroughfare is what? A public busy place. Such big, bright looking shops, glittering displays of clothes and other merchandise, means what? Thing for the sale, such big crowd. And she haven't seen such type of scenario in her village. Big shops, big crowd, big sales shops that she has seen. It was unprecedented, never known before it was for her. Struck dumb with the wonder, Valli kept at everything. Then the bus stopped and everyone got off except Valli. And at the end, she has reached at her destination. Then every passenger got off from the bus, but she didn't. Why? Because she didn't want to come outside, because she had only planned to travel by the bus, travel by the vehicle. Only that. "Hey lady," said the conductor, aren't you ready to get off? This is as far as your 30 paise takes you. So the 30 paise which you have given us, that fare is finished now. Now you have to go out of got off from the bus. No, Vali said, I am going back on the same bus. She took another 30 paise from her pocket and handed the coin to the conductor. Why? Is something the matter? What happened? Nothing is the matter. I just felt like having a bus ride. That's all. So what was my destiny? What was my move? To have a bus ride. That I did. Again, I will go return. Don't you want to have a look at the site now that you are here? Now you are here, so you can go down, you can see the sites. That can be done. Oh, by myself, oh, I would be much too afraid. No, it won't possible for me, because it is not possible, because I am alone, all alone here, and I can't go outside. It is quite thing of afraid for me. Greatly amused by the girl's way of speaking, the conductor said, but you weren't afraid to come in the bus. Now you say it, you are afraid to go outside, but you weren't. I couldn't see that you were afraid in the riding through the bus. Nothing to be afraid of about that, she answered. No, that was not that thing to afraid to ride in the bus, but go outside is quite difficult for me. Well, then why not go to that stall over there and have something to drink? Nothing to be afraid of about that either. And just go outside, just go to the shop and have some drink. That is not that difficult thing for you. Oh no, I couldn't do that. Well, then let me bring you a cold drink. Conductor was a very good person. He was a very mature person. He asked, okay, let me bring for you. No, I don't have enough money for that. Just give me my ticket. That's all. But she said, okay, I don't want to go in that particular conversation. Only I want the ticket. It will be any treat. It will be my treat and no, not cost you anything. Okay, I will give you. That treat will be from my side. It will not cost anything, not a single penny from you. No, 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 she said firmly. Please, no. I don't want anything from any stranger. The conductor shrugged. He has showed something in his shoulder. Little movement, very slow movement of his shoulder. And they waited until it was time for the bus to begin the return journey. Again, there weren't many passengers, because rural area where not many passengers go. That is why again the bus was very empty. This was the third part of this lesson. We will go in fourth part. Won't your mother be looking for you? Now conductor was puzzled, because she came all alone and now might be her mother will be looking for her. The conductor asked when gave the mother her ticket. No one will be looking for me, she said. The bus started, and again there were the same wonderful sight. And Varli wasn't bored with that, because she has seen first time, and again she wanted to take the enjoyment to the scenario. Varli wasn't bored in the slightest and greeted everything with the same excitement she would felt the first time. Again, she was similar, identical happiness was there when she again second time she was seeing all the scenario outside of the bus. But suddenly she saw a young cow laying dead by the roadside, just where it had been struck by some fast moving vehicle. You know that we have seen in the third part of the lesson that one big yellow cow was running in front of the bus, and we have seen the driver banging the horn, but she couldn't, and at last that cow managed. But that same cow was laying dead on the street. It was very, stunning picture for her. Isn't that the same cow that ran in front of the bus on our trip to town? She asked the conductor. The conductor nodded. And she was overcome with the sadness. And then she became so sad, because the cow which he had seen earlier, and that cow had given her much delightment. She was very happy. She was very, she was laughing like badly, like anything. And that time conductor asked, haven't you laughed enough? Or can't you keep some laughter for tomorrow? And that time when she was laughing, that time tears also came from her eyes. That much she was laughing. And now she has seen the picture that the cow has fell dead, or she was lying dead on the road. What had been a lovable, beautiful creature just a little while ago had now suddenly lost its charm and its life and looked so horrible, so frightening as it lay there. Legs spread eagles, means what? Spread out, a fixed stare in its lifeless eyes. First time she has seen the picture of death, which was not seen earlier by that valley. So the body has lost its charm from the cow. Body was lifeless, her eyes were staring somewhere, and there was blood spread all around. The bus moved on. The memory of the dead cow haunted her, deepening her enthusiasm. She no longer wanted to look out the window because she has seen something which was troubling her. Before she was taking the delightment of outer scenario, now she was not at all ready to see that because she has seen certain things, certain picture which was totally shattered her enthusiasm to see outside. She sat thus glued, is totally fixed at one place and her seat. You know that first of all when many people were saying her, please sit down, otherwise you'll fall down, that time she was not listening. She was stubborn like anything. But right now, when she has seen the picture of the cow, that time she was totally moved and she glued on one place, she fixed on one place until the bus reached her village at 3:40. Now the timing which she has calculated was 2:45, but she has reached at 3:40, around 1 hour late or 55 minutes late. She stood up and stretched herself. Then she turned to the conductor and said, "Well, sir, I hope to see you again." Means the desire to ride from the bus again, she maintained that. That is why she said that, "I hope to see you again. Again I will come." "Okay, ma'am," he answered her, smiling. "Whenever you feel like a bus ride, come and join us. And don't forget to bring your fare because you are so self-dependent girl. So don't feel that you want somebody's mercy and you will never accept that." She laughed and jumped around from the bus. Then away she went, running straight for home. When she entered her house, she found her mother awake and talking to one of the valizans, the one from the south street. And when she entered the home, that time her mother was woke up and she was talking with one of the aunt. This aunt was a real chatterbox. Chatterbox means, you know, that this is the quality, special quality of the woman. They keep on talking for many rubbish topics also and many important topics also for hours. They can talk for a lot of time. That is a speciality. And her aunt was chatterbox, never closing her mouth once she started talking. "And where have you been?" said her aunt when Valli came in. She spoke very casually, not expecting a reply. "Where were you?" And she was just casually, she was asking like that. She was not asking the question, "Where were you?" But she asked just. Valli just smiled and her mother and aunt went on with their conversation. "Yes, you are right," her mother said. "So many things in our midst and in the world outside. How can we possibly know about everything? And even when we do know about something, we often can't understand it completely, can we? And many things are there around us because they were living in the rural area, one of the rural area, and that is why many things happening outside the world, and even though they know, they can't do anything with that. They can't understand it properly, can we? Right or wrong?" "Oh yes," breathed Valli. Valli was there because Valli just now came outside. She has seen outer world something. She has understood the death also. She has understood the fine movement of the cow also. She has seen much green scenario also. She has seen much scenario of the train, big shops, merchandise, everything she has seen. So she know this is the world is more than what we see in the village. That is why she said, "Oh yes," breathed Valli. "What?" asked mother. "What's that you say?" "Oh," said Valli, "I was just agreeing with what you said about things happening with our knowledge." And actually both the mother and aunt was talking with each other and she just poke her nose that, "Huh, yes." That time they feel little that Valli is very arrogant that she poke her nose in our conversation. Just a bit, cheat off, Miss Confident young woman or girl, she is, said her aunt. And yet look how she poke her nose in our conversation. Just as she were a grown lady, just how she has taken part in our conversation, like she is a bigger, big woman, our grown lady, grown up child. Well, she smiled to herself. She didn't want to them understand her smile. And why she has said? Because she has witnessed something which they haven't. And that is why she smiled, but she never let them know why she was smiling. Then there wasn't much chance of that was there. Okay, she has stopped there because she doesn't want that everyone let know about what exactly she has done today. So in this lesson, we can understand that one small girl who has desire to go to see outer world, and she is successful also. She was not knowing what exactly the death is, but she has seen the death also. So that particular scene, that particular sad moment also made impact on her character, on her mind. We can see the tremendous change of the first part of the lesson and second last part of the lesson. That how she was very stubborn, she was not listening anyone, she was just trying to enjoy. And when she has seen, and she was laughing also when she has seen the cow. And again, when she has seen the cow which was dead, then total enthusiasm was lost. Okay, she has stopped to see outside. So this was the picture Brighter wanted to create. Even the small girl, she had great desire, she planned, replanned. She has made the strategy and she has successfully worked it out. Okay? And whatever she desired, it was not at all bad desire, it was not at all wrong desire. It was good desire and she has accomplished it. So that's what Brighter wants to say here. Okay, and also the willingness will make a way. Suppose you have willingness to do something which is uncommon, even though it is very difficult, it was not done before, but if you have great planning, that can be done, that can be overcome. We can suppose you have strong desire for the good positive work, you can overcome any situation. That's what Writer want to say here. So I think you have understood the lesson properly. So, till goodbye. Thank you. Thank you very much.